hello again and welcome to the fabulous vista that is, quite frankly, Blenheim Palace, home of the famous Blenheim. I'm sorry we couldn't actually get inside the building, but I do hope it's been a pleasant introduction to the world of the Doberman Pinscher. The palace itself was built in the early part of the olden days by the then King of England, Mary Queen of Spots. Were designed by Mr. Capability Brown and his assistant, Mr. Not Quite So Good At His Job Joe. The Blenheim family have always been a friend to royalty, housing Elizabeth I and her fancy man Bothwell Darnley when they fled the evil scissors of Oliver Crumbwell, who wanted to give them both an unattractive haircut. Unbeknownst to Oliver, Elizabeth I was already bald thanks to a nasty shaving accident when Sir Walter Raleigh mistook her for a potato and tried to peel her head. In an appropriate form of revenge, she beheaded Sir Francis Chichester, and he went to the galleys boldly smoking his pipe and saying, Honi soit, qui mal y pense, which, roughly translated, means, I may look a bit of a ponce, but at least I smell nice. Oh, Elizabeth I was also the natural mother of King Henry VIII and his six wives. Catherine of Aragon, Catherine Parr, Catherine Hepburn, Catherine Wheel, Catherine the Great, Catherine the Tiny, and Catherine of Anne Boleyn. The extension was built by the Duke of Cumberland to house his remarkable sausage collection. It was designed by Sir Edwin Lutyens and not, as some think, by Mrs. Edna Lupins, who is a lady who designed nothing and may not even have existed, thank you very much. In the adjoining gazebo is the music room where Edward VIII was wooed away from the throne by Mrs. Freeman Hardy and Wallace Simpson. She played an attractive fandango upon the fardle dardle. And in 1922, Columbus sailed the ocean blue. That's about all we got time for. Please do feel free to make a donut to the upkeep. And now, please do wash your hands, please. Thank you.